Today, I'm passing over to Daryl Webster, who runs Daryl as a Service, a fantastic YouTube channel that dives into more Microsoft-based stuff, ecosystem of the 365 experience. And he's going to be talking a little bit about the potential of Microsoft Loom. Now, I lean a lot on Matt from Collaboration Coach and Daryl for my opinions on Microsoft, as well as watching a lot of MITS Excel stuff alongside of it. So I've asked Daryl 5 questions about Microsoft Loom, and he's gonna answer them in a fantastic video that where he loops around a Microsoft headquarters. And I'm very excited to pass over to Daryl and allow him to answer these fantastic questions about Microsoft Loom. So a big thanks to Daryl for coming on. Please do check out all his really fantastic stuff in the comments below, and I'm sure you'll see him very soon as we dive and delve deeper into the world of Microsoft Loom in the future. Thank you very much, folks, and over to you, Daryl.
All right, I'm Daryl as a Service, and Francesco has asked me to share a few thoughts about Microsoft Loom, and I thought what better way to share than to take a loop around the Viaduct Harbour here at Auckland. So let's take a look. So his first question is, how do you go about explaining Loom to someone who's new to it? I explain Loom as a lightweight way of being able to collaborate with people in the flow of work. You start it within a conversation, whether it be in an email or a team, and you just add that collaboration space. Start to add content, get your ideas out there, and then share it. And so it's that simple, trying to explain it to people so that it's really just about getting those ideas out in the flow of work. It's real fast and in real time you can collaborate, and you can loop other people in by sharing it with the other applications that you work in. Loom is currently supported in Teams conversations and an email. You can add it to meeting invites, and it's going to be added to other applications soon. Choose from a list of components, add them to those places that you're working, and just start. There's going to be more components that are available soon to be able to start collaborating in all sorts of kind of ways, dealing with all sorts of needs. Components are simple starting points. They're just ways of beginning. So you can have a table, you can have a bulleted list, you can have a task list, and you just make a start. You can add more components as you go. So the two superpowers of Loom are that they can be quickly started and they can be quickly shared, so you can get on with working. How do you see Loom bringing the different applications together in the Microsoft 365 world? Today we see Loom as a place where you can have a basic text conversation and begin to work together in basic kind of text ways. More like a very flash way of using Notepad, but co-authoring and quick ways to start. What we're going to see is more places for Loom to be able to come into different applications. So we've heard that it's going to come into OneNote, into Whiteboard very shortly. There's been some hints too of it being put into Word, for example, and that's going to be really interesting to see what that looks like. Loom itself is also going to become something of a canvas, and we know that this is coming with Microsoft Loom as the desktop application. So being a canvas, it's going to be a way to bring content together in simple ways so that people can just get on and collaborate without worrying about which conversation, which channel, which team, which site. So in other words, Loom is going to be available in the places that you work, and it'll be about bringing the content that you work with into that place, kind of forming a loop in itself. And I believe that Loom is going to lower the barriers to collaboration and communication, because it won't matter where that content sits. It'll be secure wherever it sits, but it'll be shared within these Loom workspaces, Loom pages, and within the Loom application to make it easier for people to come together and get work done. Do I see any planned or current examples of how I use Microsoft Loom? Absolutely. I like to start with a personal chat within Microsoft Teams, because that's where I can start a loop on my own. And I can get it all ready for things like a collaborative meeting or even just ahead of a talk that I'm going to give. I also like to add it to these unplanned conversations that I have with some people where I'm on a call and I will just add it at the bottom of that chat. So this way we can take notes together and I can get quickly into a loop and start doing it with them. So there's no delays with doing that. What I also have been getting into the habit of doing is when I have to plan a meeting, I like to try and create that loop ahead of time. And I set that up for collaboration. I set it up to share an agenda, to have notes within it, and a space for notes, and also a place for tasks and follow-up actions. I might also embed or link to documents that are related to the things that we're going to talk about, so that it's all together in a loop and it's all part of the meet and invite and ready to go. I'm using all of the components as much as I can so I can understand how best to use it in different ways, but my favorite is probably the table because it's so adaptive, being able to drag content into different order and being able to get your ideas out there so you can sort things out and add content and ideas alongside it. So one of the things about trying to encourage people to use Loop is it's just this tiny little thing at the bottom of a Teams chat or an email, or you're going to start seeing it as a thing that you can insert into an application. How do we get people to start using it? Well, it's about trying to plan ahead. I think the best way is to identify a situation or scenario where you're going to use it and plan ahead of time to add to it, like the meeting example that I gave earlier. But the other side to it is to start building a habit in terms of, like, if I've just joined a conversation or I'm trying to share an idea, that I think about embedding that loop into that experience, whether it be email, chat, or wherever we're going to be working. Like with all things, it's about building habits around productivity, so it is going to be an interesting pathway to trying to encourage people to use Loop. But that's how I would frame it, to try and put it into practical scenarios and situations where it will be useful. And where do I see Loop is going to be in about a year's time? Well, let's hope that the Microsoft Loop application is available in public preview by then, that we can all start to pull our loops together, get our loops into the loop, and then we can start organizing some of these workspaces to create collaborative experiences for people. There's also going to be more components, different ways to be able to have a quick start to collaborating, stringing those together so you can create little formulas of being able to collaborate in different ways for different needs. And I think this is what the Loop team meant by atomic units of productivity, that as you put things together, they become something of a formula, a compound for collaboration. We'll see more places that we can use Microsoft Loop within new applications. I'm really excited to see what's going to happen in the Office application space and what Loop will do there. You know, particularly for Word and OneNote, I'm really interested to see what's going to happen with OneNote. Will OneNote become have a foundation as a fluid document, and that all the type of text that we type within a OneNote will become loop powered or fluid powered? Imagine doing a forward slash and being able to use a component within OneNote. Let's see what happens there. And lastly, here's hoping that we see Loop in Teams channels. You know, being able to add it to a Teams channel conversation, seeing the loop shared within the true collaborative space that we all use today, so that we don't have to worry about where that loop is within OneDrive and whether people leave, come and go, but rather that this loop will continue, persist as a place for teamwork within Microsoft Teams. Francesco, thanks for asking me these cool questions about Loop. I'm really excited to see where this is going, and I look forward to collaborating with you in the future. Cheers.